इलेक्ट्रॉन स्टैटिक्स। इट वॉज इन अ ईयर बिफोर 500 BC, ए फिलॉसफर मिलेटस डिस्कवर्ड दैट इफ वी रब सिल्क रॉड इफ वी रब ग्लास रॉड विथ सिल्क एंड एबोनाइट रॉड विद फर, देन दीज रॉड अटेन द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अट्रैक्टिंग स्मॉल पीसेस ऑफ पेपर फैदर लीव्स एटसेट्रा। वी फाउंड दैट ग्लास रॉड एंड एबोनाइट रॉड दे अटेन द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अट्रैक्टिंग स्मॉल पीस ऑफ पेपर, दैट मीन दे आर इलेक्ट्रीफाइड आर चार्ज्ड। दिस ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स विच डील्स विद द स्टडी ऑफ चार्जेस एंड देयर मोशन इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स और फ्रिक्शनल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। फ्रिक्शनल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इट वॉज लेटर फाउंड दैट द चार्जेस विच वी डिवेल्प दे आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स of charges. For example, the glass rod on rubbing with silk attains, we can call to be positive charge, and the silk attains negative charge. It's just a supposition. That means there are two types of charges, positive and negative. Similarly, if we rub any two different bodies, both the bodies they attain charges, one of them attains positive charge, other attains negative charge. The attainment of these positive and negative charges arises due to transference of a particle known as electron from one body to another. This particle was discovered by Thomson. He found that all the materials, they consist of small particles known as atoms or molecules, and these atoms they further contain small particles known as protons and electrons. Electrons lie in the nucleus of the atom, and electrons revolve around the nucleus in different orbits. This electron particle is which is moving around the in different orbits has a charge about 1.6 10 raised power minus 19 coulomb. It is the smallest charge that a body can have, and this is the fundamental particle in the study of particle physics. Now all the materials which we deal with, they can be divided in three types: conductors, insulators, and semiconductors. Conductors are those materials which have large number of free electrons. Large number of free electrons. They conduct charges. That means charges can flow on conductors. Insulators, no free electron. They do not conduct, or flow of charges take place in insulators. The charge, if it given to insulator, remains there at the same place where it is given. It won't flow. Semiconductors are those material in between, having properties somewhat common to conductors and insulators. They can be made conductors by certain procedure. Germanium, silicon, they are examples of semiconductors. Now, before we proceed further, we take the basic law in study of electrostatics, that is Coulomb's law. Now, according to this law, if we have two charges, Q1 and Q2, separated by a certain distance or apart, then there exists a force between them, and this force is known as electrostatic force, F. It depends upon strength of the two charges, inversely upon square of the distance between them, that is F proportional Q1, Q2 upon R square. Or it can be written as some constant K, Q1, Q2 upon R square. The K is constant of proportionality. And it